Hey, this is Latif Mercado, and you're listening to the Good Night Freestyle Podcast, where I take some time each night to try and reflect on the freestyle scene, where it is, where it's going, and try to figure out how to sustain it, not just for future generations to enjoy, but also to benefit. So sit back, relax, and let's talk some freestyle. Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Latif, and welcome to the Good Night Freestyle Podcast. And this is episode 71. Hope you guys are doing well. I'm doing swell. I'm outside right now. Actually, I have my microphone on my Jeep. I'm just chilling outside in the driveway. If you guys hear a little background noise, I started a couple minutes ago, and there's this train. I swear this train is far. This train is not like up the block. This train is pretty far from here. But when you hear it, and I have to get used to it, because like every night around this time, that train goes by. It goes extremely slow, and it blows its horn for the entire duration that it goes through the neighborhood. I swear it sounds like it's like right up the block, and it's not. It's far. You have to drive there. So it's crazy. And it's so funny because as soon as I hit record, I said, oh no. And it's not light. Like, you guys will not be able to hear me. That's how loud it is. It's actually crazy. From in the house, I'm okay. I could, or from in my office, I hear very lightly. Out here, forget it, you know? So I'm right off of a major highway. But I'm in a subdivision, so I'm towards the back. My house is towards the back. So I could hear it. I don't think if you guys can hear it, but you can hear the cars go by. The reason I decided to come out tonight, because it's a freaking beautiful night, man. Like, it's comfortably cool. Like, it's so comfortable out here right now. Like, I can actually pull up. I should bring my bed out here. You know, this is freezing to angel though. So I'm out here with shorts and a t-shirt and kind of leaning on my Jeep, and just figure I'd just chat with you guys. A pretty good day today. I finished the editing of book one, so I'm on schedule. I'm basically putting a lot of my time into that, so it's a lot of writing. I mean, I'm starting my writing about 6:30 a.m. and I think I worked until about 7:30 p.m. Then I went in, did a few things, and that's it, you know. So pretty early night. But then tomorrow I'm gonna start book two. And like I said, the book's already written. This for Yes Yes Y'all, books 1, 2, and 3. They are to be submitted by the 27th of March. This is the end of the month, so I only have a couple weeks. But it's cool. It's just, like I said, just editing. So the book is there. It's already written. Just going through it, doing some proofing, making sure it's on point. And I haven't read it in about a year. I have to break away from it for a while so I can get back to it. Another great thing is I just got another call. What's weird, because I got another call from Austin, Texas. Now, we were just there this past weekend. Was it this past weekend? Or the weekend before? Yeah, this past weekend. And you guys know Caroline, she went ill. And so the show really was just Angel and Sunshine. So we rocked that. It was actually a really great show. I was just looking at some of the footage, and it was a really good show. You know, sometimes when you're put up against the wall, you know, you go all out, man. You really give it all you have. I mean, even Sunshine, I mean, when I release this footage on the road, it'll be on the road, Austin. You look at Sunshine, man. Sunshine, you know, stepped to the plate. Angel's, of course, going to do her thing, man. So, you know, I'm never going to have an issue with, you know, the work she puts in. She really does a great job. So, but anyway, they called me back from Austin, another venue, and I never like to deceive them. You know, people say they'll call you and book you, and sometimes not realize that you were in the neighborhood, or I don't do that. So, you know, right away I tell the promoter, I said, well, you know, we were just there, right? He goes, oh, yeah. He goes, that's why I'm calling you back. He goes, I heard she rocked the house. I said, yeah. He goes, find me somebody else. He goes, are you guys down? I said, yeah, I'm down to do it, you know. I was trying to kind of lay low because of this coronavirus, but yeah, I can't really stop my world. I can't do that, because this could go on for months. So all we have to do is kind of hit the road and just be be careful, you know, be cautious of what we're doing, and you know, and if we get any signs, go hit urgent care and take care of it. So I'm praying that we don't get affected by this. I started coughing today. I got a little nervous, but it's usually allergies, and it's allergies because the weather's really changing. It's actually, it feels really nice out here. And but yeah, man, I just saw the news a minute ago, breaking news. It probably came out early. I don't really check out the news, but it popped up on my phone. I said that Tom Hanks and his wife caught the virus. They were infected. So, you know, when you see stuff like that, and it kind of hits home, you know, even though you don't know them, you're like, okay, well, man, they're getting it. I mean, wouldn't you think that if anybody, they would be cautious? I'm sure they don't have a problem getting any sanitizer or, you know, anything to help fight you know, the contaminants, you know. So if they can get it, and they said it was he's doing a movie about Elvis Presley, because he said it was on the set of Elvis Presley. And I didn't read further into it, but it kind of made it seem like somebody else, or maybe a few people, got it from that set. So we don't know, but that's crazy, isn't it? How crazy is that? But it's a scary thing, man. It's a scary thing, you know. And then you look, like earlier today, it says something about there was 1,000 people, 1,000 people in the United States that got it. And then like an hour later, it was like 1,100 people. And then like 2 hours later, it was like 1,200 people. And it's like, oh man, you know, like what's going on? It's scary. It's scary, man. You know, we're so, in this country, we're so used to, you know, we didn't grow up, a lot of us didn't grow up, you know, during the era of polio. I mean, I remember kids, you know, I remember adults and some kids that had polio, but I haven't seen people like that in years. But, you know, same thing with like measles. I mean, I don't run into people with chicken pox anymore. What I said, pops, chicken pox. I don't see people with the mumps. I've never seen anybody with the mumps. Angel said she got the mumps when she was a kid. I got chicken pops. I said that shit again. I got chicken pox when I was a kid. That was pretty common. Like you went to school and somebody got chicken pox. And then what was so crazy is that like if you had it, sometimes somebody like who has a kid will allow their kid to go play with your kid or go play with you, so that kid could catch the chicken pox, so that way, because they say we only get it once, and then after that you're immune to it. But it's like, I don't think I would send my kid to go play with someone with chicken pox just so they can get it. If they get it, they get it, you know. But and now like nobody gets it, you know. My kids never got it. And I don't know, do they even take a vaccine for chicken pox? I don't know. They always had all their shots. I always made sure of that. I always had all my shots growing up too. My mother made that. That was like a big thing. That was like the ultimate like responsibility. You kid got, yo, my kid got all their shots. That was a big thing back then. I remember that. I remember being a big deal. You know, my mother was kind of proud of that. He got all his shots, you know. Come to find out years later, those shots are freaking, had Agent Orange or some shit in it, you know. So, but my kids too, they got their shots, thank God. And the grandkids, they're all good to go. Everybody's good to go. So, but you know, we don't experience that stuff here, you know, those kind of diseases, thank God. You know, we need that freaking vaccine for cancer though, and we need it. I mean, the AIDS, think about it. AIDS, they even got under control. Like right now, you're better off getting AIDS than getting freaking cancer. You know, like AIDS, you can live. It's manageable. It's like you get cancer, and it's like, man, like even people that fight it, and then next thing you know, it comes back. They go into remission, and then it comes back. It's, man, it's the scariest thing, man. You know, and it gets even more scary when it's children. When children get affected by that, so, you know, anyone who's going through any of that, man, you know, my prayers to you guys, man. I've been through it with my mom, and you know, I'm you know. Every day is a new day, you know, anything can happen, you know, we can develop it, kids can develop, you know, we just pray and we just hope we can make it through this world with that, without those type of tragedies. Those are crazy, you know, and you know, sometimes you take people, you know, you get people who just take things for granted, you know. I might take it for granted. I'm a little fatty these days, you know. I should be going to the gym. I'm taking my health for granted. I mean, I'm feeling it, you know, and so, you know, I shouldn't be the one to speak. But, you know, just because I don't do something doesn't mean I'm not aware of it. You know, I know what's good for me. I know what's not good for me. I know what I should be doing. And so, but there's a difference between knowing what's good for you and then actually acting upon it. So, you know, and that's my downfall. My downfall is, you know, when I get into a good workout, I like to work out. Anybody who's followed me working, I know how to work out. I'm pretty good. A few years ago, you know, me and Angel hit the gym pretty hard. I trained her. I know my way around the gym pretty well, and I know how to handle nutrition. You'll look at me, you won't think that, but I do. I boxed, I played football. So, you know, I was always into health, and I always studied that stuff. So I went on a couple, you know, diets, but not like these diets that you've seen, but I had like, you know, high protein, low carb diets that I've done, and they've worked. But the thing is that, you know, I can work like 6 months, a year working on this stuff, and, you know, I can lose the weight. Well, it's been a while since I've lost the weight, so. But when I used to be able to do it, I could work 6 months, lose the weight. And what's so crazy is that it's like within a week, I could gain it all back. How crazy is that? That's just bananas, you know? So, but I don't blame my weight on my food. I don't. I really don't. Like, I can carve certain eatings, you know? I don't really snack. Right now, I have a bottle of water. I drink water. When I do drink a soda, I know diet sodas are no good, but that's what I'll drink. I'll drink that or diet Kool-Aid, only with my meal. So if I have like a 16-ounce bottle of ginger ale, a diet ginger ale, I'll take a sip while I'm eating, and then I'll put it back in the fridge. You always buy it in a bottle because it'll take me the whole day just to drink that one. So I don't think that's too bad compared to some people. However, I'm a little concerned with the aspartame in these diet sodas. They said it leads to Alzheimer's. And believe it or not, I know a couple people that were pretty pretty constant drinkers of diet, especially Diet Pepsi. And two people that I know, actually there's three, have developed or are in the beginning stages of developing this. So I don't know if there's a tie-in, but they said it, and then I saw this. And the reason why I attribute them to the diet sodas is because it was a big thing for them to drink diet sodas. As a matter of fact, I think they influenced me, because I remember one of them telling me, I said, yeah, man, I don't know if I could ever drink that diet soda, man. It like tastes nasty. I remember one of them telling me, she's not even here anymore. A good friend of mine's their mother, and I remember her telling me, oh no, once you start drinking it, you drink it for like a week or 2 weeks, she goes, you'll get used to it, you won't even realize it's diet soda anymore. And I did, and sure enough, yeah, it starts to taste exactly like regular soda. The difference, however, is the difference in it is when you drink regular soda, like let's say I've had people accidentally give me a regular soda, and I was like, oh my God, like I can't drink this. It was all thick and like massive sugar. And then I feel it in my stomach. Like once in a while, Angel might go to like the Spanish supermarket and she'll get like the Cola Colombia, or she'll get like that pineapple soda, you know, from back in the days, or she'll get the Coco Rico. And you guys all know what I'm talking about. And she might say, look what I found. So I'm like, okay, cool, you know. But we're not used to drinking, and we'll eat the meal and we'll pour a glass with ice, and it's like, this tastes yummy. But once we finish that glass, it's like, oh my God, my stomach, you know. So, yeah, man, you know. So, but yeah, man, you know. I just hope everybody's staying safe. Am I conscious about going on the road? Absolutely, I am. Like, you know, maybe it's a bad idea. Maybe going on the road is a bad idea, you know? I don't know, you know? Put it this way, it's a bad idea. I'm gonna be real with you. It's a bad idea to go on the road. But sometimes we have no choice. Look at everybody who has to work. It's the same thing, you know? Going on the road for me isn't just, oh yeah, I'm going on the road. It's my job, it's how I pay the bills. It's how I make a living. So just like the next man cannot take off of work for the next 30 days because of this virus, and they could be working in crowds, and they could be working in the airports, and they could be working in cafeterias or movie theaters or hospitals. They have to go to work. Same thing here. I have to go to work, you know? So all we can do is try to be very cautious, be careful. They're saying wash your hands all the time. I wash my hands all the time anyway. But I gotta be honest, I don't know if I've been washing them like the way they've been telling you. I don't know. But I do. I usually, you know, every time I pass by a sink, I usually wash my hands. I just never like anything in my hands. I touch something, I wash my hands. I come in from outside right now, I'm gonna wash my hands, you know? I throw out the garbage a little while, of course I'm gonna wash my hands, you know? I'm moving some boxes around, I'm gonna go wash my hands. So, but if I'm just sitting there watching TV, I'm not gonna get up and just wash my hands. Maybe I'll go use the bathroom, whatever. But yeah, I haven't been doing anything special, and it's not what I'm recommending. I might not be doing the right thing, you know? Then again, I might go through this whole thing and not catch anything and have lived a very normal life, whereas other people are out there walking around with masks and picking rubber gloves on and all this stuff. And, you know, I went through the airport. I didn't see that. I thought I was gonna see I thought we were gonna be the oddballs. I thought we were gonna walk through the airport and we were gonna be like the only ones without masks. And no, man. I think I saw maybe one or two people with masks on. And they were Chinese. That was crazy. But you know, they wear masks a lot. I don't know, man. Maybe they know something we don't know. But yeah, you know, they tell you be careful with the metal surfaces. Now remember, when you're going through the security checkpoint in an airport, you have to throw your luggage up on those metal, on those steel tables, those smooth steel tables. Now, they're talking about those things are conductors, man. Like, they pick up the virus, and then you go and you touch it. Now what? You know? So, that's crazy, you know? It's crazy. And then they say also to watch the air vent. So, when you sit in the airplane, the vent that's overhead, they say be careful with that, you know? I don't know, I would think maybe the shade on the plane, definitely the knobs when you're in and out of the bathroom, you know. You just gotta be careful, and let's hope that it doesn't strike home. Don't sleep on it because it could, you know. You know, these are the scary things about the world. I mean, we live in a much better time than back in the days. Back in the days, man, you're talking about this was like the 20s, I guess, or the 30s, 40s, depression. Everybody would have been dying. Like, people would have been dying already, you know? That was happening at one time. People were getting that, what was it, TB, the tuberculosis. They had quarantines. They would put people in these buildings. I think there's a building, they said Staten Island. That there's this building, I think I saw a documentary about it. Almost positive it was Staten Island, and this place used to be where they housed people with tuberculosis. And what was happening is, like, family members were bringing them there and just leaving them there, and these people were like being abused. It was like so haunting, man. It was like, wow, crazy, you know? So, you know, sometimes I look back, I'm like, I kind of wish, you know, I was born in these days. But then I think about, well, I would be dead now. I wouldn't be around right now. So I'm cool with being, I was born 66, so was Angel. So I'm cool with, you know, having been, I could have used a little time back. Like, I kind of, you know, kind of wish I would have been a little younger with social media, because I'm like a social media freak. Not that I'm all over the place and you see me posting, but I just understand and appreciate the formats, the platforms so much. Like, to me, it's incredible. It's such an incredible invention. Oh my God, people don't see it the way I see it. Sometimes I talk to people and they think I'm crazy. I'm like, do you not? I remember I used to say that about the telephone. Think about it. You get in your talk about back in the days, you know, you pick up your telephone, you're in your house, and you could call anyone, anywhere, like with the telephone. I thought that was, and I remember being a little kid thinking this was an incredible invention, you know? And then we get cell phones. You know, remember people, this was Star Trek. Star Trek was the same thing. They had, you know, where they would talk, or they would, they had the image. I don't know, did Star Trek have the image, like the FaceTime? I don't know. But look at stuff like the Jetsons. That was FaceTime, yo, when the image came up on the screen, you know, and they were talking. So, but I'm proud to be in this era. I sometimes have these discussions, like, I made it in the right generation, because, like, the generation right before us, like, let's say from, all right, so we're 50s, so our 60-year-old brethren, like my sister, my brother, and those people, they are they use social media as a gathering place, but they don't understand, because they don't need to understand, but they don't understand the impact that it has and how it can be utilized. And there's just the marvel around this. It's incredible. Just think about when we're not around. Think about what our kids and grandkids are going to experience. This is nothing. This is nothing. You know, I believe that what's gonna kick in really, really big, and I heard a couple of people talk about it, and I totally agreed when I heard it, is voice. So any of you guys who have like the, what is it, Siri or the Alexa? I have Alexa. Get into that. Learn more about that. Learn more about the Siri and the Alexa, because I believe that that's where it's gonna be. You see, when we pay for stuff, we're not paying for the service. A lot of times we're paying for convenience. So like Uber. It wasn't about, okay, well, we're paying for them to bring us transportation. No, they save us time, because we could do whatever we want until the car comes to our door, and then we could save some money, you know? Same thing with everything, with email, with, it's just time. It's, you know, convenience. And nothing is going to save you more time than voice, okay? So, like, I could sit there, I could have sat here in this entire podcast, which comes out to about 20 minutes, I could have typed this up, and it would probably take me a couple hours to type it, you know, edit it, set up the way I wanted to set up, take out all the mistakes, you know, take me a few hours. But instead, I'm using voice. And look, exactly whatever it is that I'm saying is what you guys are getting. And I could time it. You know, right now I'm at 21 minutes and 11 seconds. Okay. So, so voice is the key. We're going to start everything. Hey, turn on my car. Hey, it's already happening. It's nothing new. It's already happening. You got cars that are driving themselves. Do you know they have washing machines that, I don't know if they're on the market yet, but the washing machines that they can tell when you're low on detergent, and it automatically orders the detergent from you. I think it orders it from Amazon. And it times it so that way you never go without detergent. And I heard also that they have a refrigerator. I don't know if it's in the market, but they're either working on it or it's available. It's probably $1 billion. All that stuff is going to come down in price. So don't even worry about buying that stuff now. I'm not buying that shit right now. I'll wait till that thing is about, just like I waited, you know, I had my cell phones. I used to hate paying the freaking bill every month. I was like, man, I can't wait till this shit is like unlimited. Sure enough, it was unlimited. I had my phone, but call me after 9, man. Call me on the weekends, you know, which was perfect for me because I went on the road on the weekends. That's really the only time I needed my phone. And at nighttime was usually the only time I really used my phone, because I talked with a lot of California people, you know. But they have this refrigerator that the shelves can tell what you have in there and when you're running low. So if you're running low on milk, it automatically orders the milk for you. How crazy is that? And look at like the Walmarts. Now you can order them online, go pick it up. What's that about? Time. They're saving you time. And all they gotta do is make sure that when you get your stuff, that you're happy with it. Because if you go there and you're like, oh man, they didn't give me the right brand. Oh man, this meat sucks. They picked the meat out for me. They picked like the worst cut. Once they improve that and they get to the point where they're giving you the best cut and they're giving you the best products and they're giving you the best prices and they're shopping today, that's when you're going to use them all the time. And there's going to be no more stores, man. These stores are all going to be checkouts. I really believe that. I really believe that. I can't say in 20 years I think they'll still be around, but I would say maybe a good 50 years, I don't think we're going to have many stores. I think everything's going to be online, everything. Like, what are we going to do? Where are we going to go? I think the only place we're going to go is going to be virtual reality. So we want to go someplace, we're going to put on these glasses and then take a hike. You know what I'm saying? Or get on a treadmill with some those virtual reality glasses, and that's how we're going to go see the world, you know? Because we're going to have everything at our fingertips. Everything's going to be delivered. So if you don't force yourself to go out, you're not going to have any reason to go on. The same thing with jobs. These jobs are all going to be online in a minute. I mean, come on. I mean, really, you know? You're going to have some things that I don't even think, you know, garages. I think it's going to get to a point where, you know, they're just going to bring you a new car. Oh, your car's messed up? Okay, here, you know. I think they're all going to be electric, so we're going to plug that in on the curb of, you know, It's gonna be that setup is gonna be on our driveway. It's already there. They already have them, you know. So, but anyway, guys, it was a good discussion. Think about what I'm saying, you know. Don't forget, please subscribe. I go to my YouTube. I can really use the subscriptions. Please like, share, whatever you can do with the podcast. Let people know the podcast is out and about and that we're doing it, and you know. But I appreciate all you guys listening in. It means a lot to me. And until tomorrow, good night, freestyle.
Before I lay me down to sleep, I pray to hear a freestyle beat. For if I die before I wake, I hope to make it to the break.